Hi, my name is Gerald Hetrick. I'm the Chief Technology Officer of Vox Mobile, and we're here to talk a little bit about BlackBerry Enterprise Server 5.0. So if you're like most enterprise organizations, you've got end users, sales folks, field force people walking around carrying BlackBerries, and they're most likely connected to a BES server for kind of email redirection and policy control and whatnot. You've probably heard about BES 5.0, maybe you've even done a migration already, but if not, I want to give you a little bit of a rundown and a quick chat here about what are the new features and kind of key points around BES 5.0, and what are some of the different migration options. So from a core new feature perspective, some of the really cool things that are available in BES 5.0 is the new web-based administration console. This is available via the BES service. It's a new service. It also allows you to expose some APIs. You can write, you know, other systems into adding and removing users or whatnot. There's a built-in enterprise transporter tool. This allows you, this is kind of the holy grail, what we've been wanting from this tool for a long time. This allows you to move users from one BlackBerry domain to another without having to wipe and reactivate them. Built-in high availability and monitoring, and you can now customize the administration roles of your administrator. So maybe some people can just add users, some people can just remove users, whatnot. So now that you've learned a little bit about what's available in BES 5.0, the question is, how do you get there? You know, how do you migrate? And there's two core options, just like all IT systems. You can do an in-place migration, where you upgrade your existing environment, or you can do what I recommend and what I've typically had our engineers do out on client sites is in side-by-side migration, which really involves, you know, building a new environment, getting it up and running the way we want it, test it, and then migrating the users from one to the other using the BlackBerry Enterprise Transporter tool we mentioned previously. So why would you do a side-by-side migration? What's compelling about, you know, the new features of BES 5.0? Why would you want to do that? Really, there's a couple things here. So the first is downtime. Do you want downtime? Is downtime acceptable? I'm betting not. And doing a side-by-side migration in the BES world has never been easier than now to limit downtime. You know, do you want to take advantage of the high availability features? If so, you probably want to build the new environment and test your HA features and test your DR plan before having production users on it. Do you want to take any of the components, maybe, you know, the router component or the BAS component to a remote server? Do you want to put them, you know, for security or additional HA concerns, do you want to put them in remote servers or a remote geographic location? Do you want to move the database? We see this all the time. So people's BlackBerry environment grew out of, you know, an old implementation. It's got a production, you know, production user base on a local version of MSDE or SQL Express or even a full version of SQL Server, you know, not using or on a server that can't handle it from a resource perspective. Doing a side-by-side migration is a great opportunity to move your SQL database that hosts the BlackBerry config files or BlackBerry config database to a production-ready SQL server. Do you want to move the BES server to a new location? You know, this is also very common. Maybe your data center's moved or you want your HA components to be in a different, you know, geographic data center. A great opportunity to get all that set up, get it completely deployed, you know, get it tested, get it documented, and then move the users in a kind of a phased step-by-step approach. And finally, you know, was your previously deployed environment from a BES perspective, did you contemplate much growth? Do you have, you know, are you ready to add more servers? Are you ready to add more components to add users or to take on additional applications or to do, you know, mobile voice system or whatnot? Building the new BES 5.0 environment from scratch in its own isolated scenario with test users on it gives you a great opportunity to kind of answer all these questions and to be prepared to take it, you know, take the environment to be, you know, really enterprise ready, really mission critical, and you can sleep easier at night. So thanks again, my name is Gerald Hetrick, I'm the CTO at Vox Mobile, and you'll see me do a couple more video blogs about this topic specifically. We'll dive into things like monitoring and high availability and the BlackBerry Enterprise Transporter tool with some deeper level functionality and feature talk. Thank you.